Welcome back to Ozarks Fox Fame. It is Wednesday, our favorite day of the week because we get to visit with our best friend forever, for life or longer, Michael Babcock of TMZ.
Hi, Michael.
You love when I say that, right, Michael?
It gets bigger every year. I mean, every week.
What an introduction. That was...
Hey, Michael, can I just tell you good news, too? Good news.
Yeah,
Here in our market, TMZ Live has moved to 2 p.m. So I've been watching it every day now because I'm usually asleep when it airs.
I've seen you on there too. I'm like, oh my gosh, there he is.
Yes.
That's great. That's great news. I see Charles. Charles is happy too.
Yes. So guess what? TMZ Live is on at 2 p.m.
Yeah.
And I've been watching every day.
Yeah.
Seeing him and Harvey, and then regular TMZ is on at 5.
That's awesome. That's great.
Excited.
I'm glad you can watch now.
Yes.
Yeah, because we're usually asleep.
They throw me on there every once in a while.
Yeah, I saw you not too long ago.
Can I just say they need to put you
sometimes
on more? I'm just going to vote for you right now. Put Michael Babcock on way more segments.
I'm going to tell them. I think they might be able to actually even hear.
Okay.
I was trying to say it loud.
That was very loud. Yes, it was.
Say more money, Jeremy.
More money.
More money. Okay.
More money.
We think you deserve it, Michael. We really do. So we've got to talk about the thing that everybody wants to talk about.
Yeah.
Britney.
And today, that's Britney Spears, Kelly. This is a huge day for Britney Spears. I mean, it literally could be the day 13 years in the making, because it is possible that the conservatorship, after more than a decade, could actually end today. So we've been talking about this. I think it's almost every week that we talk about a new development in this Britney Spears saga. And she's been trying to get to the point where Jamie, her dad, was out as conservator, and the conservatorship was then gone altogether, period. No more conservatorship. Well, today there is going to be a hearing, in Los Angeles via Zoom. Britney will not be a part of the call, but Britney's dad, Jamie, and her mom, Lynn, we are told, will both be on the call. Of course, there will be the judge and a bunch of attorneys as well. And there was originally a hearing for the end of January that they were going to discuss this conservatorship ending. Well, that has been moved up until today. So it is likely that they are actually going to present arguments for why the conservatorship should end. Now, it's interesting in the fact that there's nobody arguing that the conservatorship should remain. Mom, dad, and Britney, everyone says the conservatorship should end. But that doesn't mean in itself that the judge is just going to say, okay, well, you guys all think it should end, conservatorship done. I mean, it's possible that could happen. With the people we've spoken with, though, it seems unlikely. What's more likely is that the judge could order some sort of mental evaluation. That is what Britney has said she has not wanted to do. She didn't want to go in front of a bunch of doctors and be poked and prodded. But that's what originally got the conservatorship put in place 13 years ago. A mental evaluation, felt Britney wasn't capable of taking care of herself at the time, and that has just remained in place. So you could see why the judge would want to say, hey, if we did the mental evaluation 13 years ago and you needed it, let's make sure the doctors agree that you don't still need the conservator. So that could certainly happen. The judge could also order mediation, where he basically says to Britney and Jamie and Lynn, hey, you guys figure out how you're going to transition out of the conservatorship. Who's going to deal with your finances? Who's going to help you during your day-to-day life? That's also a possibility.
So, but
the bottom line,
I have a couple thoughts. I want your thoughts on this.
Here's
the thing. Like, do I think it will be overturned? Probably, because the court of public opinion has been so strong. Mm-hmm. I just started watching the new Netflix documentary last night. And then her fiance goes on Instagram Live. And that Instagram Live did not put her in the best mental state, if you watch that. And she was screaming by the end. And I was just like...
He was saying that this morning. It's like, that doesn't really bode well for her.
Yes.
Remember, Britney... I think maybe it was 3 weeks ago now, we talked about it. Britney had deactivated her Instagram, and that was to show, hey, I'm taking this this hearing really seriously. This is serious business. But then she was back in a matter of days, and I agree with you guys. I think most people agree that some of the things that she says and posts on social media, it doesn't help her case. Sometimes she appears unstable, and that's... The whole point here is to show that she is stable and can take care of herself. So to appear out of control, even on Instagram, look, the judges are people, and they see and hear these things. And I don't think it helps her case. And it'll be interesting to see how Instagram has affected, how social media has affected whatever the judge ends up ruling today. It's going to be fascinating to see. I agree. It does not help her case.
The bottom line is money, all right? And the dad was worried about the money. Everybody just needs to stop with the money. I don't think she's mentally right, or I don't know that she ever will be, but it's her money. If she wants to blow through it, let her go.
The funny comments on Instagram have been, congratulations on your engagement, get a prenup. Congratulations, get a prenup. That's all I'm seeing.
She is, Jeremy.
She is.
It was fast. Right after she was engaged, I'm not kidding, Kelly. It was the next day. We had spoken to people in her camp, and they said, "Yeah, we're already getting going on a prenup here." She had one for Kevin Federline, and she's going to have one for Sam Asghari as well.
Well, that shows some stability.
There's some mental stability right there.
Right.
Maybe the judge look at that. Don't look at Instagram.
Don't look at Instagram. Social media. Okay,
we can't wait to see what happens today with that.
Yeah, it'd be very interesting. Mm-hmm.
And then I hear, now, see, I knew when the Kardashians canceled Keeping Up with the Kardashians,
they weren't done with TV.
No, they weren't done.
No.
I know. It was funny, actually, to see some of the people who loved watching Keeping Up with the Kardashians for, 20 seasons, 14 years on the air, and people were genuinely upset that, where am I going to get my fix of the Kardashians? No, they were barely gone. And yesterday they were in Malibu at a place called Lucky. And it was Kim, Courtney, Khloe, and they were presumably filming for this new Hulu show. We don't even know the name. We just know that it's supposed to premiere later on this year. But the name of the show unclear, exactly what's going to happen on the show unclear. But it does look like they are underway filming the new show.
I wonder if Ryan Seacrest is producing it, or who is producing
it. Right. Did that deal with him end with the E, or is he still part of them?
That's a good question. Yeah, I don't know the answer, Jeremy. He is such a savvy businessman, though. It wouldn't surprise me. And obviously has a relationship with them.
Can you text Ryan Seacrest really fast and find out?
I can't, but Harvey can.
Oh, I bet he can.
Ask Harvey for us. They can't stay gone either.
No. Well, I just saw a clip. I don't know what show they were on, but Kris Jenner was mentioning how she missed the cameras.
Yeah. When you have that outlet for so long and then it's gone, I think in ways you do miss it. The camera people had become almost part of their families. They were there for everything. They were there all the time. So, yeah, you're right. It is interesting. They started on traditional television, right? They were on E, and now they move over to streaming. So I guess they've kind of evolved a little bit after a decade and a half on traditional television.
I'm trying to think of good names.
It should be interesting to watch.
I don't know. I did enjoy watching them sometimes, and it was on a timeline when I could. So if I get a chance, I will.
Can't keep the Kardashians down. I'm trying to think of the cuts.
And don't even try.
I know. I won't.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you, Michael.
We always love seeing you.
Thank you so much.
Have a great day. See you next week. All right. TMZ weekdays at 5 p.m. TMZ Live weekdays, at 2 p.m., like you said. Stay right there for something else coming up.
We don't know. Drink your coffee.
Yeah. I'm going to have some more Skittles. I'm getting my sugar on.